please stand for the national anthem of Barbados? Please remain standing for a prayer by Jackton Chase Marshall.
Good morning. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you this morning for your goodness and your love. We recognize we are unable to do things in our own strength. We thank you today that we are able to have this press conference to inform our Caribbean family of our issue results amidst the various challenges and sacrifices. Our move from the old headquarters to our new location, setting up and getting everything into high gear. And we want to thank you for our teachers, our ministers of education, and also our dedicated staff complement, from the supplemental staff up on to the head of the organization. We thank you for your indelible contribution. We know without you, these things would not have happened. Thank you once again for being our guide as we move on to our next phase of this cycle with new ideas and strategies. I pray that we will continue to grow from strength to strength as we set out to complete our CXC mission. In Jesus' name we pray, thanksgiving. Amen.
Now you can be seated. Put your hands together at one time for Ace Works Community Steel Palace. Honorable Ronald Jones, Minister of Education, Science, Technology, and Innovation. Honorable Harcourt Husbands, Parliamentary Secretary in that ministry. Miss June Chandler, Prominent Secretary in the ministry. Mrs. Karen Bess, Chief Education Officer. Mr. Glenroy Kamabach, Registrar of Caribbean Examinations Council. Mr. Kimal Prasad, Director of Corporate Services at CXC. Mr. David Clement, CXC Local Registrar, Barbados. Mr. Fernando Carter, Senior Education Officer, Curriculum, Ministry of Education. Dr. Charles Mayenga, Senior Assistant Registrar, Examinations Development and Production Division. Mr. Noel Stennett, Senior Assistant Registrar, Examinations Administration and Security. Members of the Technical Advisory Committee, Chief Examiners, representatives from partner organizations, Senior Assistant Registrars of CXC, principals of secondary schools and their representatives, education officers from the ministry and curriculum officers, CXC staff, members of the media, ladies and gentlemen, good morning. Good morning. Since 2010, official public release of results of CXC has become a feature of the CXC's annual calendar. 5 years ago, this event was occasioned by adverse circumstances in Kingston, Jamaica. Circumstances which affected hundreds of candidates writing CSEC and CAPE that year. The question then was, how can CXC present the results of those candidates in a way that demonstrated confidence and integrity in the examination and the processes used? The answer was to go to the stakeholders and present the results to them and an explanation of the processes of CXC, and to be transparent interaction between CXC and its stakeholders. Over the last 5 years, the event has grown by leaps and bounds, and so far it has been hosted in St. Vincent and the Grenadines, 2014, St. Kitts and Nevis in 2013, Guyana in 2012, and Antigua and Barbuda in 2011. Additionally, CXC has partnered with the Caribbean Media Corporation, ZIZ in St. Kitts and Nevis, SVG Television in St. Vincent and the Grenadines, and NCN Television in Guyana to broadcast the event live from those countries. Today, we are still partnering with CMC Carib Vision, Creative Junction, and the Media Resources Department at the Ministry of Education to ensure that the event is viewed by a worldwide audience via the internet and Carib Vision television network. Thank you to CMC for your willingness to cooperate and to bring quality content to the region. Today, ladies and gentlemen, CXC will present the results for the region of the examinations offered in May-June 2015 for the Caribbean Advanced Proficiency Examination, CAPE, the Caribbean Secondary Education Certificate, CSEC, the Caribbean Certificate of Secondary Level Competence, CCSLC, the Caribbean Vocational Qualification, CVQ, and the Caribbean Primary Exit Assessment, CPEA. On behalf of CXC, I want to welcome you to this event, not only those of you gathered here in our new headquarters today, but also those following us on the World Wide Web and via Carib Vision channels and networks. I will now introduce you to the principal speakers today. Honorable Ronald Jones, Minister of Education, Science, Technology, and Innovation. Welcome, Honorable Jones. Thank you. Mr. Glenroy Cumberbatch, CXC Registrar. Mr. Cumberbatch. Mr. Noel Stennett, the Senior Assistant Registrar, Examinations, Administration, and Security. Mr. Stennett. Dr. Charles Mayenga, Senior Assistant Registrar, Examinations Development and Production Division. Dr. Mayenga. Mr. Fernando Carter, Senior Education Officer, Curriculum, Ministry of Education, Science, Technology, and Innovation. Mr. Carter. Mr. Glenroy Cumberbatch is the Registrar of CXC. Mr. Cumberbatch joined the Council in 2007 as pro-registrar based at CXC's Western Zone office in Jamaica. He was appointed registrar in December 2014. Ladies and gentlemen, join me in welcoming Mr. Glenroy Cumberbatch as he brings remarks.
Good morning, thanks Cleveland. Honorable Roland Jones, Minister of Education, Science, Technology, and Innovation. Honorable Harry Husbands, Parliamentary Secretary, Ministry of Education, Science, Technology, and Innovation. Ms. June Chalice, Permanent Secretary, Ministry of Education, Science, Technology, and Innovation. Ms. Karen Bess, Mr. Kamal Pasaw, Director of Corporate Services. Mr. David Clement, Local Registrar. Mr. Fernando Carter, Senior Education Officer, Curriculum. Dr. Charles Mahinga. Noel Stennett, both from CXC, members of the Technical Advisory Committee, chief examiners, representatives of partner organizations, senior assistant registrars of CXC, principals of secondary schools, education and curriculum officers, Ministry of Education, CXC staff, members of the media, ladies and gentlemen. That is a mouthful. Thanks very much for coming today. But before we begin, I would like you to stand to a moment's silence for Doreen Pyle. She was one of the key educators in the Caribbean, in Barbados in particular, and one of the geography experts and a very outstanding principal. So let's stand and for a moment's silence, please. Thank you. All right, where do these results fit? And principally, let's look at our education over the past number of years. And as we develop, we have universal access to primary education in almost every country within the CARICOM area, except for Haiti. We are close to universal secondary education. Some countries still have not reached universal secondary level education. We have significant expansion of post-secondary tertiary level education, and our average school years have moved from about 4 years in the 1960s to about 10 years per student in today's world. But we still have some problems. We have relatively low access to early childhood education and development. We have low performance in primary and secondary schools, and every person continues to speak about that. We have an imbalance in CSEC entries. For example, we have people who do English A, but who don't necessarily do English B. And if English B is the language that we are trying to develop and the level we are trying to develop at, then it's important for us to do both of them. We have secondary and tertiary graduates with inadequate skills. We have a high stratification of learning outcomes of achievement. So we have several differences going on that we need to address. But we still have some issues. Despite the achievements that we've had in the region, crime and violence still seem to dominate. And also, we have very high unemployment among youth. In some instances, it is as high as 50%, depending on the countries, and it is highest among females. And as we go through the presentation, you will see that in some subjects, females, we have four times the entries for females as opposed to males. But at the end of the process, we still have high unemployment among the same female class. So we need to put some new emphasis. We cannot see results just as a process of persons having grade ones, grade twos, and grade threes. The education has a purpose. And one of the purposes of education is to build better societies. And we have to focus on how do we translate all of these subjects that we do into building better societies. And how do we transition from secondary school and tertiary education levels into employment? The economy depends on those people who are better educated to come back into the economy to generate jobs for themselves or for others in order for us to progress. So, how does CXC contribute to that? CXC is trying to build itself into a way that we can continue for this for many years to come. And we want to strengthen our business model. We cannot just rely on governments for financing, and we cannot just increase our fees every year or every 2 years. We have to find other ways of doing business. So we have to strengthen our business model, we have to secure our financial stability, and we have to enhance our stakeholders' experience. How do we strengthen our business model? One of the things that we are going towards is professional examinations, where we are contracted by some professional bodies to do the examinations for them. One of those bodies is the regional nursing councils. They're contractors to do this. We are having discussion with other medical and professional bodies in order to provide the exams for them, and we are working with a country to produce their examinations for the licensing of their teachers. So we are continuing that process in trying to build capacity and to build our brand across the professional examination spectrum. We also focus in on out-of-school populations. When you look at our numbers, a significant portion of our numbers is out-of-school. At one stage, the numbers used to be dominated by in-school candidates. Now, upwards of 60% of the persons who register for examinations are out of school. They're not in any institution preparing for examinations. So we have to cater to them more. It's just not a matter of offering our examinations. We have to offer learning material and other things to them so that they have a better chance of being successful at their examinations. And we also look in the other Caribbean territories outside of the English-speaking territories. We have already entered into St. Martin and Saba. We are focusing now on improving those numbers in Suriname and also in St. Eustatius. So we will be, St. Eustatius for the first time in 2015, will be going to an English curriculum, and CXC will be the examining body to examine, to certify the students in those programs. And we have some persons, some Caribbean nationals in the diaspora. We're trying to reach them for subjects that they may be very well be interested in. Those subjects could be Caribbean history, they could be Caribbean studies, they could be other things that they may very well be interested in. And we will try to reach out to that market and provide some kind of certification for them in those areas. Financial stability. We need to do more marketing of our products and services. CXC have some of the best kept secrets in the region. Lots of persons do not know the breadth and the length of subjects that we do. So you will meet people from time to time. Do you do technical drawings? Yes, we do technical drawings. Do you do business building and mechanical drawings? Yes, we do that also. So many people are not aware of this, of the extent of what we offer, and we are going to be offering other subjects which try to tie into the economy of the region. Entrepreneurship is one of them, green engineering is one of them, logistics and supply chain, all of those different subjects we are trying to bring in so that persons who graduate and who get certified do not have to rely on persons to give them a job, but they can create employment for themselves and create employment for others. We have to utilize the appropriate technologies. We cannot rely on those, well, I almost tempted to say outdated methodologies, but they may not be totally outdated. But we have to try to find new ways of doing our business, which adds to the quality of what we do, but reduces the time that it takes to do it and the amount of labor intensity that is involved in it. And we need to review our way of doing business. We can't do business as usual and expect to reach the levels that we have reached. We have to go past that and we have to find new ways of doing it. And our stakeholders are key. For the last 2 years, we have put a lot of emphasis on our stakeholders, and we will continue putting that emphasis on stakeholders, because the right people are key to helping CXC achieve what it has to achieve. We're going to be focusing on the right people, both in terms of our staffing, both in terms of our examining committees, our panels, and all the other groups of persons who contribute to us. And we will be providing training, we're providing other areas of support to ensure that those people provide the best quality work that we can get out of any person in the region and in the diaspora. Adherence to quality standards. We cannot vary from the standards that we have. And constantly we ask some questions sometimes that seem to suggest that we need to be a little bit more lenient. We need not to bother about some things. And a quick example, if some person missed an examination because they've slept too late, CXC should be able to give them a grade, because the student now cannot achieve his or her promise of going to university and studying. Now, that becomes a little bit difficult to do. So we need to stick to our standards. We need to constantly explain those standards to persons so they understand, and so that we can provide a quality product consistently every time. And we need to embrace innovation. For the beginning, CXC embraced innovation. When no other examining body focused on criterion reference testing, CXC did. When no other examining body focused on the profiles, CXC did. So CXC was a leader in those areas. So we have to continue to be innovative. We cannot stop at this point and make a decision that we have reached. We're going to stop there, and we are not going to be innovative as we press ahead. So we will continue being innovative. Now, Mr. Stennett, all right, so I'll stop there and then maybe move on.
Ladies and gentlemen, a round of applause for the registrar. Thank you very much. We'll now be entertained by Ace Work Community Steel Band, and as the group comes, I'll just tell you a bit about the group. It's a community steel band program directed by Ms. Glovina Springer. Today's group is the primary section of the band of 20 players. Ages range from 6 to 16 years old. The group is also involved in community service. Put your hands together and welcome Ace Work Community Group. Thank you. You can do a little better than that. Thank you very much. East Works, beautiful Barbados. Thank you. Mr. Noel Stennett, Senior Assistant Registrar, Examinations, Administration, and Security, has over 20 years in the education sector. Mr. Stennett joined CXC in January this year. Please make him feel welcome as he comes. Mr. Noel Stennett.
Thank you, Mr. Sam. Ladies and gentlemen, Minister, Parliamentary Secretary, ladies and gentlemen all, it is indeed a pleasure and an honor to be able to speak to you on some of the operational matters regarding the issue of our results. Before I begin going into the formal presentation, I'm permitted by a particular country to make a statement which I believe will help us to set in context some of what it is that CXC does and why it does it. The cohort going into high school in Jamaica in 2010 was 52,000. The cohort exiting grade 11 in 2015 was 40,140. Question may be asked, so what happened to the 12,000 in the interim? The 12,000 in the interim, the local, the country has its means of dealing with them, A-STEP, GNAT, NVQ by heart, NTA. But CXC also seeks to look at that picture across the region and to provide some answers. The answers, I think, are contained in the slide that we're now looking at, where we provide answers, we provide the means by which students, youngsters, and older persons are able to further their education, obtain qualifications, and be able to fit into the world of work or move on to higher levels of study. The next slide, ladies and gentlemen, shows us focus on our CAPE regional examinations, the candidate entries and the subject entries. We have a quick comparison between the years 2011 to 2015. This obviously speaks to the need of persons to move on into tertiary education. And you will note that the entries between 2014 and 2015 have been roughly maintained from 29,000 to 30,000. Again, basically the same number of subject entries, albeit that there was a 4%, an actual 4% fall. As we look at the comparison between males and females taking the examinations, we note that the population varied between 61% females and 39% males, and we have the actual numbers there, 11,500 males as against 18,300 females. Please note that as we have moved forward, we've tried to develop additional subjects which would meet the needs of various constituencies within the region. And here we have a list of the new subjects which were made available in the CAPE 2015 examinations. We had a total of some 3,176 entrants to those subjects, and they range from agricultural science, entrepreneurship, performing arts, physical education, and tourism. We move now to CSEC regional results. Please note that we had in 2014 approximately 142,000 entries. This year we have 132,000. We had 600,000 subject entries, and this year we moved to 5,780 within the same basic range, albeit that we might note an 8% fall in candidate entries and 4% fall in the subject entries. The apportionment between males and females, please note that we have a division which is perhaps closer to our population, 59% females and 41% males. Another of our products which has seen some movement, you will notice that over the last 4 or 5 years, we moved from a high level of take-up, but that within the last couple of years, we've been roughly maintaining at about 5,500 persons registering for the CCSLC examination. These have been divided between males and females roughly, with 51% of the entrants being females and 49% being males. The next of our products, the Caribbean Vocational Qualification, has been seeing some growth in various territories, as you will see there, some which were not participating in 2014, our home country Barbados, for instance, have seen a significant take-up for 2015. And the final of our products that we will be looking at this morning, the CPEA, the Caribbean Primary Exit Assessment, please note that of the four territories which have been participating, there has been relatively steady participation. We have a total number this year of 3,927 entrants making use of this particular product. We therefore have been able to offer products spanning the range from primary to pre-tertiary education, and therefore to offer opportunities for a variety of individuals across the region seeking to improve not only their knowledge and skills, but their opportunities within the region. I'd like to spend a few moments also speaking about this move into the future which represents electronic marking. The journey began somewhere back in 2010, and we've had four iterations in 2013, 2014, and in January and May, June of this year. The journey, therefore, has been one which has been paced, it's been reflected. We've had the opportunity to look at issues and to try to address them, to bring together the various technologies in the interest of improving quality. Basically, to speak about the essence of electronic marking, I would want to touch on the 4 points that we see represented under the process. Scripts are essentially scanned so that the markers are no longer handling the actual paper. It gives a certain measure of security also with those papers, that they won't be lost, for instance. The markers are given particular quotas initially, and depending on how well they perform with that quota, papers can be either added to their portfolio or removed if they're not marking in accordance with the expectations. A critical element within the process of electronic marking is what we call seeding, where seeds are pre-marked scripts which are placed within the marker's pile of papers, and where you have randomized within every 10 a seed, one of these pre-marked papers, which the marker encounters. Now, if he's marking on target in keeping with the mark scheme, he will move forward to another 10. If he's not marking on target, the seed will indicate that there's a problem because he will mark out of tolerance with that seed. Our system is that, in essence, after two of these errors with the marking of the seeds, one is pulled from the group and the next section comes up where the examiner, the supervisor, then has to review the work of that particular individual to make sure that it is desirable to have him continue. So he's re-standardized, as it were. If he is seen not to be able to make the standard, then he would be pulled. So we have from these various elements a few improvements, which we have mentioned here, improvements in quality. The quality of the marking, obviously, is increased by the impartiality of the seeds. If you're not marking to the seeds, you're automatically identified. There's no matter of relationship or talking your way out of it. The seeds have identified you, and that is that. The examiner continues to sample the work of the markers, as happened in the old face-to-face system, with the important thing being that, having been identified for seeding, by the seeds rather, one is re-standardized and asked to mark. Now, if that happens again, that you get knocked out by a seed, you are pulled from the marking pool. Convenience is also one of the main improvements. Markers sometimes have children, and the marking may have in the past required that you travel to a foreign country. In the electronic marking profile, you are able to mark from home, from anywhere, and at any time. So it brings greater convenience to the marker and also to the supervisor to be able to work within the parameters which are to one's advantage. The third improvement which I'd like to touch on is the fact that the electronic marking allows the marker to exhibit and to work within his own initiative. So if he finds, for instance, that he is able to do 500 a day, that's up to him. If he can mark from 8 in the morning to 12 midnight, that's up to him. He's not limited by the 8 hours of the day. And he can look at the structure of the payment structure and the type of questions that he's asked to do, set his own goals, and accomplish them on his own initiative. In 2015, we essentially moved to e-marking some 67 components. Those are subjects, paper one, paper two, sorry, unit one, unit two in regard to CAPE. In the coming year, We will move to, as you see on that slide, some 75 Cape subjects, 37 CSEC subjects for May, June. And in January, we will have 22 subjects being e-marked. So we're moving towards full implementation of e-marking in all of the subjects. I touch on a further area of quality assurance, ladies and gentlemen. We, over the course of the year, we have been doing SBA audits, and the audits are really a way of our trying to ensure that the participants in our programs are, in fact, allowing the students to have the opportunity to develop, to discover, to research, and so on. We did audits in Barbados, Guyana, Jamaica, Trinidad and Tobago, and basically the audit selects certain centers and certain subjects, and we do a careful review ourselves and the local registrar, who is a member of the local Ministry of Education, to ensure that indeed the SBAs have been properly done, have been consistently done. Another arm of this quality assurance measure is the on-site moderation of science subjects, which was done this year in all territories, and this further allowed for greater transfer of information and guidance to the local teachers, as the moderator would go on site, have a look at the samples, and be able to communicate directly with the teacher. What I've tried to illustrate, ladies and gentlemen, through these numbers is that CXC has, over the past years, and indeed this year, sought to provide products which are fit for purpose, products which relate to students of all ages, abilities, and interests, as our mission statement indicates, and that we continue to do this by looking at other means of, as the registrar indicated, of moving into professional examinations and so on. I thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you very much, Mr. Stennett. Up next is Dr. Charles Mayenga. Dr. Mayenga has over 20 years of experience in education assessment and high-stakes examinations. He previously worked with Assessment Strategies, Inc. in Canada as a senior consultant, and I now invite Dr. Mayenga to present the 2015 results. Dr. Charles Mayenga.
Thank you, Cleveland, Honorable Minister. If I go through to read all the names, I won't finish reading the results. Allow me to proceed. Thank you. Just one correction on my colleague mentioned of the components that are being e-marked. Those ones were subject papers. We will be having 35 papers being e-marked and 75 papers. Not the subjects, but the total number of papers within some of those particular subjects. He also mentioned about the new subjects. Since I don't have them in my slides, I'm going to mention them up front so that we can get the numbers for those particular subjects. The subjects that my colleague mentioned, which are new this time, and they're not in my slides because I didn't really have the comparisons, so you'll see that I'll focus on the comparisons, and therefore they are new. I don't have the comparisons, but I'm going to give you their performances. Their performances are quite excellent. Agricultural Science Unit 1 had 90% attaining the grade 1 to 5. Agricultural Science Unit 2 had about 97% attaining grade 1 to 5. Entrepreneurship Unit 1 had 96% attaining grade 1 to 5. entrepreneurship, grade unity 2, had 100% performance, attaining grade 1 to 5. The other subject that was mentioned was performing arts, had 98% unit 1. Performing arts, unity 2, had 100% performance. Physical education, which was mentioned as a new subject, 99% performance. Physical education, unity 2, had 100% performance. Tourism, unit 1, had 98%, attaining grade 1 to 5. Tourism, unity 2, had 94%, attaining grade 1 to 5. The other limitation why I could not put them here in terms of that, you will see that the numbers, some of them were very small. I don't want you to go with the numbers that are actually not very correct. Minister, allow me to proceed with the rest of the presentations in terms of, as a brief outline of things that I will do, how we assess, and I'll try to follow what my colleague did in terms of CAP, CSEC, CCLC, CPA, and then I'll end with CVQ. To start with, it's just very clear that the method that we use in terms of assessment is that it's a criterion referenced assessments that we conduct. It's not a norm referenced assessment. Because sometimes people ask, what is the percentage you're expecting to pass? What is the percentage you're expecting to fail? We don't do that. That's a norm referenced type of assessment. If you pass, you pass. If all of them pass 100%, we provide the results 100%. Unfortunately, if they also fail, we'll return the same results. They failed, and we'll let you know that. So it's a criterion referenced, which means once you meet the standard, you pass. If you don't meet the standard, then you fail. So sometimes, unfortunately, in my presentation, I'm going to mention some of the subjects where we have not performed well. It's not norm referenced, it is criterion referenced, meaning that once you meet the performance standards, those are the results that we provide. The registrar mentioned that CXC has been one of the leading examining body over the years because it does quite unique things that many other examining bodies don't do. Reporting by modules, reporting by profiles, and reporting all types of results to the candidates. Some of the examining bodies, you find that they focus mainly on the scores, the overall total, without looking through the modules or without looking through the profiles on how they have actually performed. Most important, which was mentioned here, is that CXC combines with the SPA. I will mention, I happen to come from Kenya, that most of the African examining bodies, after inheriting from the British systems, they tried the SPAs and actually abandoned it halfway. They did not continue. So we have to commend ourselves at CXC that we have maintained that particular model because it strengthens our assessment. It provides an all-round assessment in terms of not only at the end of the year or at the end of the school year that you assess, but you have a process in which you assess throughout the year. That's a great thing that we need to commend ourselves. I'll start with the CAPE results. And the grading system that we use is 1 to 7. And the criteria we'll pick there is that those ones with 1 to 5 are acceptable. And once in a while, I'll also mention what percentage obtained grade 1. But most of the time, I'll be focusing from grade 1 to 5 as acceptable grades. And those ones who, in some cases, I'll give you the results for those ones who have a grade 1 when I'm making the comparison. Since we are in Barbados, but we're also aware that this is being shared across the region, I'll have to be very mindful about that. But Minister, you're the host, I'm going to mention, and in some cases, I'm going to compare you with the rest of the region. And where the comparison is relatively different, don't take it so personally. but take it to mean that there's some work that needs to be done, and that is a message that I have to share with you, being the host, just as much as we shared last year for those ones who are hosting. So when I make those particular comparison, it's nothing to do with, I'm not leaving the other regions or the other countries as such. It happens that we are hosting it here, and therefore I'll try to make those particular comparisons. And where there's some good messages, I'll share that. And where it's not that good, I will point out that. By the way, I live in your constituency, so next time make sure that I can vote. Mr. Minister, to start with CAPE results, when we look at it in terms of how many obtained the acceptable grades, because we have defined the acceptable grades as 1 to 5, we can see that first thing is that it's comparable. So you have to commend yourself, sir. Yeah, you're not far behind, it's comparable. But the next time you'll say, well, I need to go up. So it's comparable. That's the first message that I want to communicate here, that in terms of the overall results, 90.5% compared to the region in CAPE who attained the grade 1 to 5, which is 90.7. I'm not going to do statistical difference between 0.5 and 0.7. So round the number to 90% or to 91% as obtaining grade 1 to 5. But when you look deep into the results, my second point is that 90% in Barbados had in 39 units out of the 56 units. 75% acceptable grades in 46 units out of 56. The question is, how many of these units did Barbados perform better than the region? So I decided that I create a question here, and I need, I don't know, minister who you'll appoint to answer this question, your chief examiner, your permanent, chief education officer, or your permanent secretary, who do you want to answer this question? The options are 0 units, between 1 to 20, 20 to 30, 31 to 56, none of the above, all of the above. Who would you like to answer the question? No, I don't want you to be put on the spot, sir. Because right in the room, my measurement officers, who I want to thank for preparing all the questions, I'll share with you the number of the questions. Minister, the question is a bad question. Because the options are not, we don't do that. So I won't put to you, sir, that kind of question. A, I've said how many units? A is 0 units. That's I need to send this question for grammatical check. B, 1 to 20, between 1 and 20, and then C, 20 to 30. There's an overlap, sir. So can't you don't know which one now. Right. So that's a bad question that he's asking you to respond to. That 1 to, and between 31 and 56, this one's a bit better. We don't use none of the above in all our questions. That's a bad question. All of the above. So the answer is that, Mr. Minister, you had 29 units out of the 56 units where Barbados performed better than the region. I think we need to commend ourselves for that and the club for the wonderful work that we did. How many of those particular units you had, as I said, this is a criterion referenced testing. So if you get 100%, Charles and Dr. Broom and the others who are members of TAC are not going to make those adjustments. So how many of those ones you did extremely well and you had 100% attaining between grade 1 and 5? The answer is that 12 units. We need to clap for ourselves on those ones. Let's clap for those wonderful results. And these ones here, you can see which are some of those particular units. The other one, I didn't care whether you see the units, but you can see some of those particular units where you have 100% obtaining grades 1 to 5. The question we have to ask ourselves while we commend ourselves for those 12 units, which ones are missing? By this particular slide, you have to ask yourself which ones are missing so that we can focus on those particular units that are missing from this particular list. And you would see that there's quite a number of them. Depending on the focus in which the ministry is having, you have to ask yourself, and some of these ones, the ones that we want to focus on. I don't see many of the sciences. I don't see some of the critical subjects like sociology, Caribbean studies. I don't see some of those particular subjects there. So we need to ask ourselves, how can we improve the performance of some of those ones? But as we have said, we have to commend the teachers, we have to commend the schools for giving us at least 12 of those units where students have performed quite very well. But what about those ones that are missing? Minister, allow me to now go into the details of some of the subjects, and I've selected a few subjects to give the results, because if I go through all of them, it will take a bit longer, and we'll try to make sure that there's some comparison. As I said, in some cases, there's a decline. In this particular one, accounting unit one, there was a decline in performance, where Barbados had 96% in 2014, had 92% in 2015. Particularly if you look at grade one, you'll see that it was a big decrease in terms of those ones who attained grade one. And that's what we need to look at. There will be a subject report that comes out from CXC. Teachers need to pay attention to what are some of the challenges that students encountered. The region, an overall again decline in that from 96 to 92, which is the same decline that we saw for Barbados, particularly where there is grade one, decreased from 23% to 9%. Again, the subject reports outline some of the challenges that were there. But when you look at Unity 2, the performance increased 79 to 96 for Barbados, whereas for the region was from 79, the same percentage, to 91%. But as I've said, my concern is that Unit 1, look at it and see what the subject reports talks about. I picked the Caribbean studies as one of the subjects because it's an essential one. When we talk about the PIRA, we talk of all the studies, the things that as we train the human resource across the region, the performance is relatively stable and comparable. When you see my graphs, I'm not expecting that we will try to get the exact numbers. Let's use the idea that if you see my three lines traveling apart, then we have a problem. You will see some notes below it. If you see my graphs staying together, then you know that it's stable, it's comparable. So when we look at the next one, having given you the criteria, see the difference? I wanted us to participate. By the time I finish my numbers, people will be dosing off. I want to make sure that I keep everybody as we go through. This one, Caribbean Studies, we have said is stable and comparable. Is that right? The next one, then if I read the notes below, you can understand what is happening. Is that right? We are together. That the performance is comparable, but we do see some differences there. 99% attained grade 1 to 5. Compared to 98%. So that's why I say it's comparable. But when I look closely at grade one, I can see that you had 22%, the region had that 13%. Let's clap for ourselves on that one. When we look at management of business, someone told me that I have to be careful in terms of time. I'm trying to speed up on this. In terms of management of business, again, the performance here, Barbados did better compared to the region. You can see that 91% attained grade 1 to 5 compared to 88%. That's a good number. That's more than, my criteria usually is that anything more than 5, that's good performance. But how many attained grade 1? How many attained that grade 1? You see that you did very well overall. But when you look at it in close proximity, in close detail, you'll see that you had 2% attaining grade one. And therefore, sir, those results that we send out, those are some of the details we'd like people to look at, not only the overall, but also look at the details in terms of that. The next one, it's obvious, not many notes, because the graph is stable and comparable. But then still, when I'm saying it's stable and comparable, it doesn't mean you don't have homework. We need to do better. we need to make sure you can pull out of the group. You want to make sure that you can improve the performance. The next slides will focus on the sciences, physics, chemistry, biology, and I will go very quickly. Stable results for physics unit one, unit as well as unit two. Because as I've said, you can see the graphs are quite stable on those ones. Chemistry, similar pattern that if we look at it for unit one, that the results are also stable and comparable over the 3 years. But when you look at unit two, you see some gaps. You'll see that you did better in unit two, where you had 97% compared to 93% for the region. Most important, for grade one, you had 44% attaining grade one compared to 30% in the region. So that's a good performance. Again, we have to clap and thank the teachers for the wonderful work that they are doing. Look at biology. Again, that's why I put this all together, the sciences, physics, chemistry, and you can see where you are. Remember from that earlier one where I said that we didn't see some of those particular subjects. Those are the things that we need to look to make sure that these particular subjects also show up among either the 29 or among the 12 that has got 100% performance. Biology unit one, you had 95% attaining grades 1 to 5. Compared to 89% for the region. Most important again, for grade one, you had 31% attaining grade one compared to the region where you had 24% attaining grade one. That's a good performance again. Let's clap for ourselves. Biology, unit two, comparable results. So I don't have to spend so much time on that one. Sociology, comparable results. And this is one of the subjects that I find quite very informative, because if you look at through the questions, you can see the kind of things that are actually examined in some of those particular questions. And that's why if you can focus on those ones, not only the what you might call the sciences or the technology, but these ones here, they help with what the registrar mentioned about preparing for the Caribbean citizen. Unity 2, again, stable performance. The literature is in English. When you look at that particular performance, sir, those are the ones that I'm mentioning that how can you improve this one? When you look at the literature, the performance for Barbados is slightly or is lower compared to the region, 77% compared to 88% in the region. Sir, those are many points. We wish it would be something like 5 points. It would be a difference of 4, a difference of something like that. But when it is about 11% gap, then there is a gap. We cannot hide it. We have to say it out loud that we need to do more in these particular subjects. In fact, even for grade one, well, the difference is between 5 and 2, which is 3, doesn't fit into my 5, but still there's a gap. So this particular subject illustrates some of those particular subject areas where we need to look at. Unity 2, slightly better performance, 93 compared to 90, but that's not a big gap. So we need some improvement there. We look at those ones attaining grade 1, 4% compared to 2% in the region. Again, it's not, we like to improve, we like to make sure that we excel. I picked the next subject because the performance is generally low, not only here where you find that it is 54% attaining grades 1 to 5, but the whole region is 65. So there are two problems. 65 is not a good performance for the region. 54 is even not better for the Barbados. So I don't want to keep it and say, you know, there are some subjects here we did very well. But for this one here as an example, is a subject which A, in the region needs some improvement because the performance is 65. Barbados needs to pull up, sir, because the performance is at 54. So we need to look at that one. Barbados needs to look at it closely because those ones attaining grade one is even much lower. It's 7% compared to the region. So this particular example, there are other subjects as well, but when you pick the numbers, look at those numbers closely in that order so that you can be able to see how that particular subject has performed. Unit 2, a similar pattern that we saw in Unit 1, where the region had 84%, relatively better, because 75 is more or less a cut of 80 compared to 96%. So while the region might be saying, sir, we are okay, you know, that's what they will say. But once they say that the region is doing very well, 96% obtaining grades 1 to 5, you will be saying, I'm not at that level. I need some improvement in that particular area. You'll be looking at grade 1s. This is comparable, similar performances. So it is the overall. I do suspect it is grades 2 and 3 that need some improvement so that you will be in the same level of the other performances. So, sir, that concludes the for the CAPE results. Those ones were examples that I was using. And the next one, I will try to go quickly to use the, to present the CSEC results. The criteria for CSEC results is basically the first three grades. We will call them as acceptable, and the percentages that I will be providing will be based on the first three grades, grade 1, grade 2, grade 3, as acceptable. And in some cases, I'll point out where we have the percentages for grade 1. Overall, 95% or more of those who obtained 95% or more for grades 1 to 5 were in these particular subjects: economics, physical education and sport, physical education, sport, and theater arts. Which particular areas, remember that question that I gave you, where Barbados performed better than the region? We had 14 subjects out of 34 subjects where Barbados did very well. So we need to commend ourselves for that, because that's quite a... We would like to have more. Remember the other one, we had quite 29. I would like it to be slightly more than that. Probably if you get up to a half, that's a better performance than... This is slightly below that particular performance. 69% attained grades 1 to 3. Compared to the region, which had 68%. So in that case, we just there. Is that right? Because it's 68, 69, I'm not talking of statistical difference, even absolute difference is just a difference of one. So it's not a big one. But which are these particular subjects? Which are these particular subjects? That one should be 13. I'm sorry, it should be 13 out of 34. These are the subjects that where we had a better performance. My earlier one mentioned 14 should be 13, where we had better performance compared to the region. Just like I said for the CAPE, these are the subjects where we have performed better than the region. And that's good, and we need to commend ourselves for that. But the question we also ask, which of those subjects are not in this list? Which those particular subjects that we have not performed better? Because sometimes when we present the results, people focus on those ones which are there. Just like when you are feeding your children, it's not those ones who are at the table. You also ask, what about those ones who are at the table? Because you need to leave food for them too. So the same question, let's ask ourselves, which subjects are not in this particular list that we don't have for Barbados so that we can perform well. The same applies to other countries, the other region who are also listening or participating. When they look through their results, they need to ask themselves which are some of these particular subjects that they have not performed well so that they can make some improvements on those particular areas. I'll illustrate examples with English and English A and mathematics, how we have performed. As far as English A is concerned, again, the performance has been stable the last 3 years. As you can see, the region had 59% in 2014, attaining grades 3, and 59% in 2015, exactly more or less the same percentage. When you look at Barbados, there's a slight small improvement. I call a slight small improvement. For me, anything, you know, it's a simple math. As my grandmother taught me, anything that you count with two hands, that's a lot. Anything you count with only one hand, that is small. Is that right?
Yeah.
Yeah. So this one, so it's an improvement, but I can only count it in one hand, so it's not a big improvement. I need one that I can count with two hands. Better, One I can count with my hands, and then I can also count with my toes. Is that right? That's what I need. Those are the simple stats in terms of how you translate these percentages to our lay understanding. That it's a very small improvement that I can only count with my one hand. It's a good improvement if I can count it with my two hands. It's even a better one if I can count with my toes, if my toes are not covered with the shoes. Okay, mathematics. This one, I think there's some improvement. I can now count the improvement in mathematics with more than one hand. Is that right? We need, that's right, yes. 48 to 57% for the region. Yeah, you see, she's right. She's not interested in the region. Let's clap for the region. And then you have identified your homework. Because exactly, that's a message. You looked at it and said, where are we? 63% compared to 67. She didn't have two hands. She only said, I still have only one hand. So that was a good homework, and you picked it very well. So my lesson, I think, is working. As I've said, for the region, there was a big improvement in mathematics. And therefore, those particular countries or regions need to look at it and see the programs that they have put in place. I do understand that quite a number of countries have put some programs into mathematics, and maybe that is what is starting to show up in these particular performances. We had some good improvement in principles of business. There was an overall increase, quite a tremendous increase in principles of business, where Barbados improved from 73 to 91%, attaining grades 1 to 3. The region had from 76 to 93%, quite some improvement. Small improvements or some improvements when you look at office administration, where we had from 59 to 78%. The region had from 74% to 87%. The next ones, chemistry, physics, biology, I will go them very quickly because I like to put them together. Comparable results, when you look at it closely, 60% in Barbados compared to 59. How many had grade 1? 9% compared to 10. So still your one hand, is that right? You know, very close there. When you look at biology, again, this one, while it is very close, difference of about 6, you had a lower performance compared to the region because it's 60% compared to 66. Those ones attaining grade 1, particularly, Barbados was lower compared to the region. Again, that's about a difference of about 4%. Physics, slightly lower, where you had 59 compared to 61%. In grade 1, exactly the same percentages that were witnessed in Barbados compared to the region. As you can see, I put those three subjects very closely so that you can easily see them as a group, where you're doing and how you have actually performed. Electron EDPDM, how the performance is slightly lower compared to the region, a difference of about 6%. Those ones attaining grade 1 in particular, that's why I think one of the reasons I picked this one, because the performance for Barbados is quite low, 9% attaining grade 1 compared to the region. Social studies, similar to the way we talked of Caribbean studies or sociology, one of the essential subjects. This is, in Barbados had slightly lower performance compared to the region, where we had 62 compared to 64. Grade 1, 1% compared to 3%. As you can see, some of these ones are quite important subjects. And 62 to 64, that's not really good performance. We need to make some improvement on a subject like this one if we really want to make sure that our children acquire the basic necessary skills. Information technology, you are at 80% attaining grades 1 to 3 compared to 88% in the region. Again, it's more than one hand. It's about 8% gap, and that's the gap that you need to look at. The gap in terms of grade 1 is 24 to 27%. It's relatively small, but overall, you can see that you have a gap of 8 points when you look at those three areas. This particular subject, I had quite some debate in myself in terms of how to present it, but honestly, the results were lower, and I had no choice other than to mention it. 59% for Barbados, and 35% for the region. I mean, for in 2015, that's a big decrease. That's a big decrease in this one. The region had 63% in 2014, and that decreased to 45%. I do expect this particular one to perform relatively well, but the performance seems to be quite low. Even when you look at it and take this 2014, the performance is generally should be in the 70s, it should be in the 80s. The performance is quite very, very low. Principles of accounts, stable performance. The Spanish, stable performance. Geography, stable performance. I picked two technical subjects which I would like to share with you, because I felt that we have left some of those particular subjects and they have not been mentioned here. How are we doing from some of the technical subjects? I have technical drawing, and I think I have the other one should be geometrical. In terms of technical drawing, the performance in Barbados was 78% compared to 64%, was a decline, a decrease in performance. Particularly if you again look at grade one, we had 16% compared to 7%. When you look at the region, had 78%, the same general decline that we saw in Barbados. A decrease in terms of the percentage attaining grade one from 16% to 8%. Another area from the technical subjects, building and technology woods. This one here is relatively stable, because if you look at that graph, particularly for the region, you can see that it's quite stable. But you need to look at it in terms of how they are performed and how many of those particular, when they get the detailed results. How are we doing? Are we together? I've lost some people. No. Too many numbers? Okay, great. I'll briefly present the CCLC results, which I think is mentioned as one of our subjects, and glad to see that we have quite a number of countries. We know about it in terms of that it gives quite some strong foundation, and the options, you have quite flexibility in how you package the CCLC in each particular country, in each particular region. It's not really as, there's some room and there's some flexibility on how you, what you can do with it and how you can actually work through this particular program. One of the things that we probably should mention that we shared last year was that this particular assessment was benchmarked by the UK company, and they found that it's quite equivalent to many assessments beyond the region. Particularly, it was equated or benchmarked to grade 9 in Ontario, grade 10, I believe, in grade 9 or 10 in US, and therefore it's quite a good program, not only in terms of where it's benchmarked internationally, but also the flexibility that it gives each particular territory on how they can actually handle. Having said that, when you look at the list of the countries that are participating, then you ask how many of these ones that are not in the list that have not participated in this particular program. When I look through the questions, when I look through the assessment that is done, it's quite a rich program that has got quite a lot of interesting programs there. The number of candidates, as you can see, the number is not quite great. Mr. Stannard mentioned the big numbers of candidates from Jamaica, for example, or from other countries as such. We like to have a large number in those particular subjects. We have a large number in English, mathematics, but relatively quite small numbers in those particular areas. I have to mention that CXC is moving forward to introduce another language in this particular area, that it will be Portuguese. So among those three languages you're seeing there, we will be having Portuguese at CCLC level, which will be similar to closer to the French and Spanish that we have in that particular category. And therefore, you're given more options, more opportunities, and therefore, it's for us to take those particular opportunities and come on and participate. How was the performance? Relatively, in terms of the average there, you can see we are in the 60s. We like it to be higher. We like it to go up to 70s. if possible, 75% will be a good performance. You can see most of them range between 58 to 68, 68%. We like it to be higher. Most important, we would like to have a large number of candidates attaining the mastery level, the one that you're seeing in blue. You can see a large percentage are in the middle category, which is, we like to expand the blue group, that is the mastery category, and have fewer in the lower, in the green area, so that we can have more who have attained those particular skills, because CCLC has got really good skills that we try to prepare the candidates for, and CXC, I think, is embarking on the idea of trying to see what's the connection between from those ones who are doing CCLC and how they proceed to perform in CSEC as well as in CAPE. Again, I don't want to lose everybody by now. Coffee or tea must be very close to be getting ready. CVQ, what is the trend? I think we saw these numbers. I'm not going to spend a lot of time here. But the slide here gives you an idea of the gender representation again, where we have more male participating in these particular programs compared to the female participating. And we saw that in some of the cases, we had quite a large number of female participating in some of those particular programs. We wanted to make sure that we are all represented in these particular areas. How many of the candidates have been awarded the units? When you look at the gender distribution again, you'll see that the large number of them are actually the male awardees. When you look at the number of candidates who have been awarded a full CVQ, again, you will see that a large number is the male population. We also want to make sure that we have a large number on the female population. This list gives you which particular areas. I'm not expecting that you'll be able to see in detail in all those ones, but it's a general idea, and we'll share this particular PowerPoint through the ministries and through our website, is to get an idea of which particular fields or which particular areas that have got a large number. You can see that one of the largest is the data operation, electrical installation. Those are some of the skills that we need, but we cannot also ignore some of the other areas which are quite essential that we need to have. Furniture making, software furnishing, some of those particular areas which are quite critical. Some of the transcripts which have been awarded, you can see again, we saw that data operation is the main one there. But we also need to include some of those ones, especially when we have some of our people looking for jobs and they're wanting to participate. They need those particular skills. CPA is one of my favorite programs because when I look through some of the work that we go through, you actually see a lot. Last year, I gave an example that when you look through the work that has been done at this particular level, the question you usually ask you ask yourself is that what has happened in between? Because the skills that they demonstrate at this particular level are quite good skills. I'll give you an example that you find the students are able to edit their colleagues' work. You cannot edit somebody's work if you don't have that particular skill. You cannot correct somebody's work if you don't have that particular skill. Most important, it's a good program because students can write questions themselves and which they can use for their own colleagues or which the teachers can take and use. I cannot write the questions if I don't understand that particular area. So I find the CPA is one of the very good programs that we do have. In terms of the candidate enrollment, I think will have been shared with you from Mr. Stanley's presentation. The performance that I would like to give you is this one here, where we have we like it to be in the same level. When you look at the performances, for example, in the sciences, which is quite relatively high, but when you look at the mathematics, the performance is not very high, it's low. We need to make sure that we can improve on those particular areas where you find that it's below 60 as such. We like it to be improved so that we can have higher performance. Personally, the criteria I usually try to say is that if something is 3/4 way, it's a good performance, but if it is below that, then that's not a good performance. And most of these ones, they fall below that criteria, and therefore we want to make sure we do that. Minister, I know that I've taken so long. I'm going to summarize to where I started, so that those are the numbers that I would probably like you to keep or probably go back with. That overall, we are comparable, but you can take a difference and say we have, you're 2 points away from the rest of the region, because you will take 90.5% minus 90.7, you will see a gap. But if you focus on that gap, that's a wrong message. The message is that there's some particular places where we need to focus on, and those are the particular subjects that where we missing. The last one in particular, where you would say, and the message is that we had 29 units where Barbados did very well. That's good, and we need to go home with that particular message, but also with the message that there were some that we didn't do well. Which are these subjects that we did not do well? Because if we go with that message alone and say that we did very well, that's true, that is correct. But there's also some of those particular messages that we want to make sure that we want to include them in those particular areas. For CSEC, again, we have seen that most of the results are quite stable. In some of the cases, very, very comparable between 2014 as well as 2015, very, very comparable. Even sometimes when you look at it, I think the next one should be Barbados. For the mathematics in particular, that was English in the first one. For mathematics, that's where we need to commend ourselves for the good work and the performance that we have seen in the mathematics. And I singled this one out. I do believe that there must be some programs that have been initiated out there. And if there is indeed some improvement, we need to congratulate ourselves and commend the teachers, commend the people who are doing the good work. The story I normally give is this. The story I give is a lizard was in a wall, in a roof somewhere, and then it dropped down. Once it dropped down, it looked up, saw how far it had come. It was still down there and it was still alive. Looked around, there was nobody. What did the lizard do? It nodded the head. I survived. I congratulated. Whether it is any one of us, when we see that kind of improvement, even if you are alone, and you see that you have made that improvement, we should all commend ourselves, we should commend our teachers, and commend the programs, particularly for the mathematics. Last numbers, because I've shared so many numbers, I don't know which ones you have kept in your head. I'm sure you have kept that you are comparable, 90% compared to the region, 90%, 29 out of 56. As for CSEC, I'm sure you have kept the same numbers, 69% compared to 68%. We have 14, I think there were 13 where we have done better compared to the region. The numbers that I have not given you is where I want to thank all the teams that have worked with us over the years, over the months, the hours, to produce the results that we have presented to you. The results that we have shared with you has been a long journey, whereby many of the items, many of the questions have traveled for many, many days and many, many hands to produce the results that we have. If you didn't know, for example, in multiple choice, we used a total of 4,260 multiple choice items that CXC administered in 2015. I was not able to count the other questions, so many other questions that were used to administer that. And if you take that, you can see how much work that went into that. Particularly the e-marking that was mentioned, the number of marking that has taken place, and the number of images that have actually been scanned to produce the results. So I want to thank everybody who has participated in this particular process so that we were able to share with you the results. And particularly my colleagues, my measurement officers, some of them who are listening, some of them who are in different places at this particular location, I want to thank them for the wonderful work that they have done, as well as everybody in the unit or at CXC for us to produce these particular results. So, sir, those are my brief or long presentations, and I would like to end at that particular point. Thanks so much.
Uh,
Another round of applause for Dr. Mayenga. And I think after all of those numbers, we should really be entertained now again by the group so that we can get back some level heads for the minister's address. Welcome Ace Works as they come again to entertain us, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much. Something's happening. Ladies, put your hands together one more time as they leave. Thank you very much, Ace Works. You did a very good job today. Ladies and gentlemen, we come to the stage for our feature address. It will be delivered by Honorable Ronald Jones. The Honorable Ronald Jones joined the Parliament of Barbados in 2008. Sorry? 2003, my apologies. Minister Jones received his primary education at the St. Bartholomew Boys School. Subsequently, he attended the Washington High School, where he obtained his secondary education. He also pursued studies at the Barbados Community College before he entered the University of the West Indies, Cavill campus, where he was awarded a bachelor's degree in history and sociology. Minister Jones also attained a master's degree in education management administration from the University of London and a certificate in teacher training from the Erdiston Teachers College in Barbados. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome Minister Ronald Jones.
Thank you very much, Mr. Sam, Ms. Juden Chandler, Permanent Secretary acting in the Minister of Education, Mrs. Karen Bess, Chief Education Officer, and all other distinguished officers of the Minister of Education, Science, Technology, and Innovation, the Registrar, Mr. Glenn Roy Cumberbatch, and all other distinguished members of the Caribbean Examination Council, all principals who are assembled here from our various educational institutions in Barbados, and hopefully one or two others from the Caribbean, members of the Technical Advisory Committee, chief examiners, partners in education, members of the media, ladies and gentlemen. It was not long, because I was, in truth and in fact, quite taken by the statistics presented. I am going to keep calm today. Let me say to you, it is a single pleasure of mine to be with you this. This is still morning. Well, it's morning. It's after 12, but still morning for me. On the occasion of the official release of the Caribbean Examination Council's 2015 examination results, my immense pleasure is fueled by the fact that the Caribbean Examination Council came into being since I was an educator. I believe I still am. The classroom calls me as I look at some of the results that I've seen this morning, both positive and negative. So really, I'm one of those persons who was able to see this organization develop to the status it now commands, from its infancy to about 41 years now. So some 41 years ago, the need for a homegrown examination body was answered when this fledgling body was formed, and I've seen the organization reach maturity. This examination body now holds the credibility, integrity, and relevance which gives it recognition internationally. Now the results which I shall receive later, I saw that on the program, have been derived from examinations that are creditable, reliable, and have great validity by any international standards. So we can be quite proud that when our students take those examinations, that they have not been watered down, they have not been corrupted, and they can stand, those certificates once awarded, can stand the test of time. We should applaud all of ourselves for that. And they're therefore comparable and acceptable anywhere in the world. I was listening to the what NARIC, which is the body you were talking about, benchmark the CCSLC, and it set it at quite a high level. I know we're getting, even in Barbados, a bit of, still a bit of discussion on that exam, but the Minister of Education is 110% in support and is, of course, urging all of our schools to progress towards writing of that exam, and I compliment those who have so far. In its efforts to ensure credibility, The Caribbean Examinations Council does not limit itself to the offerings of assessments and certificates of qualifications. It concomitantly offers preparatory programs to assist students. Caribbean Examinations Council programs such as Tell Me More Language Learning Software Pilot, so that, you know, language acquisition could be further developed right across the various languages. Strengthening second chance education, second chance opportunities. We know as educators that there's some of our students who don't benefit at the moment, but there's so many moments in time. And therefore, the provision of other moments in time for those students are, in fact, quite important. And we note as well the Notes Master Project. All are welcome innovations, and there are some innovations that have been mentioned, the marking solution, an extremely interesting and innovative way of trying to get the scripts marked and back a bit more before time. All of those are important strategies and innovations being put in place by the Caribbean Examinations Council. And that is saying it is an evolving examining body. We've also heard mention of the other areas, one in the Caribbean, who are becoming part of the Caribbean Examinations Council's initiatives and programs, St. Martin, Saber. You mentioned them all, so I wouldn't repeat them in case I make a mistake. Now, all of these innovations, all of these new strategies, all of the various methodologies that are being applied are really for the benefit of the learner, are for the benefit of the students. And even though it is a streamlining of many of these things will make it easier for production, it is the student at the end of the day who stands to benefit from these various systems and processes. Now, transparency is among the major elements or one of the major elements of integrity. And the fact that the Caribbean Examinations Council joins with one of the territories yearly to host the ceremony bears proof that the council is willing to be transparent with the result it presents to the region. So I'm glad you're here in Barbados. If you look at what is said by, what is it called? Something, Transparency International. It says that Barbados is one of those very, very transparent countries. And therefore that you are here, and the others that you have gone to in the 5 years that you've been bringing this result, we also talk about their own transparency, but particularly the transparency of an institution such as the Caribbean Examinations Council bears testimony to the work that you have been doing and maintaining both the validity, the reliability, and the integrity of this exam says a lot for the council. The standards of administration and conduct of the various examinations are clearly developed and fully articulated through the careful establishment of appropriate structures and instruments. When problems arise, as problems will arise, that's the nature of us as human beings, the relevant manual presents clear guidance of the procedure to be followed for resolution. There was one I didn't fully understand, which was clearly explained to me by the registrar. As last night I was going through the CSEC results for Barbados, I noted three things, but I just wanted one to be explained. Results withheld. And I saw a few on what came to me as being withheld for Barbados, and I got the explanation. So the registrar doesn't only sit at the top of the institution. He knows what he's doing, he knows what he's talking about. I hope your explanation was correct. Well, it made sense to me what he was saying. So it had to be correct. I don't want to put I had to give you that. So when problems arise, that's payback. I remember you from so many years ago, Senator Husbands. We remember him as well. Up to now, I can't find my clothes that he hid. At Erdiston, it was not a nice thing. The benchmarking of the validity of the council's examination helps to fortify both the integrity and credibility of the results presented to the region. This process is carried out, you know, of course, the benchmarking by other reputable international agencies, like in this case, NARIC and the CCS LC. The relevance of an education system influences efficiency, its efficiency and effectiveness, which help to keep the system on the cutting edge. CXC is on the cutting edge. It is one of the outstanding examining bodies of the world. Don't nobody tell us that it is, you know, not that. It is one of the outstanding examining bodies of the world. And therefore, it is one of those in the entities or bodies in the region that have stood the test of time. And all of you who have worked with the Caribbean Examination Council over the years, those who have led it, those who have been in the council, who sit on TAC, and all of the other bodies, sometimes as people in the region, we don't give ourselves enough praise. Today, let us take our praise and applaud ourselves for your work, your commitment to our peoples, and for standing the test of time and presenting ever-evolving standards and examinations for all of our people. Now, the council, in addition to the traditional systems of formative assessment, and I like the criterion basis for your assessment, the council has moved to include summative assessments through the Caribbean vocational qualifications. And you know that in Barbados, and I believe across the region, the CVQ gives that transportability and movement to people. So the standards will be similar. So somebody moves with a CVQ in data, what is it called? Or in masonry, or in carpentry, or in photography, or in cooking, that you can move easily across the region with this qualification. Again, I'm pleased to note the leap in numbers so far. And I see the principal of Darrell Jordan here, one of the leaders in this particular area, and all of the other schools who are gradually improving the number of students who are taking the Caribbean vocational qualification. We need it. We need competency-based certification, skills acquisition relative to these types of qualification. And giving technical and vocational qualification the ranking and the status that it truly needs, not only in Barbados, but across the wider Caribbean region. In keeping with the trend of certifying students for their achievement at all levels, the Caribbean Certificate of Secondary Level Competence has been developed and is being implemented at some schools across the region. As I said, from the statistics which have been shown, there's still a bit of uncertainty in the minds of many persons across the region in relation to this. There's always costs, and costs might be part of the challenge, particularly those students who might have to pay them for it themselves. Don't let it be a challenge in Barbados, even though we're still having some challenges. I believe that the state still carries responsibility for the payment of examinations for our students. And I have not been told by anybody that we should not be carrying that responsibility. And that is why sometimes I am concerned myself. I am when I also see on the statistics and the information provided that 1,365 subject entries were not taken by our students. They're paid for, and CXC does not refund. Is that true, Registrar? You don't refund. And therefore, that is a challenge. Yes, I know that some students can be ill on a given day. You can examine those, but some people might get cold feet. You can't get cold feet when you're well prepared, when you're confident, when you're assertive, when you need to go and do those exams. So 1,365 is a little too many within the numbers that we do send forward. I didn't calculate the percentage. I just prefer to give the raw number. That is too many. Now, I'm going to conclude shortly, but I want just to spend a bit of time, because I know you've been here for a little while, on the results as presented. We need to get more students doing our exams in the region. That's a fact. We know the number of students that go into all of our schools in the region. And therefore, the number of subject entries are still not enough. It means that the system is leaking too many of our children. That's what it means. I use the word leaking. And eventually that leakage is going to cause a flood of further despair within the region. And we have to avoid as much despair in the region as possible. We already have many social challenges. And I believe it was you, sir, who looked at issues of crime and violence, issues of unemployment, and some other social disruptive behavior that can cause disruptive behavior. And we know as well that persons who benefit to the highest degree from education from as much as early as primary level and feel that sense of success, that feel or that develop assertiveness, confidence, that they look at their own self-esteem, are less prone to move towards negative behavior. So there must be a correlation between some of the issues taking place in the social sphere of the Caribbean and how they feel at the end of the day about the change that should have taken place in themselves as a result of education. I hope you understand the point that I'm making here. So in our schools, we have to redouble our efforts. And I'm not speaking about Barbados alone. I'm speaking of the entire region. We have to redouble our efforts as leaders of education, and I include principals, deputies, and all of those in our schools, year heads, as we call them in Barbados, senior teachers, head of departments, master teachers, whatever, or whoever in the senior level of education, must bring to bear a level of influence to rank and file teachers. Get them to understand their role, their responsibility, the regional charge for our young people. You understand what I'm saying? So it is not simply accepting what is, but looking to change to achieve what must be for the region. Yes, here in Barbados, I look with some satisfaction on some areas of success, but I also look with some dissatisfaction in some areas where we were not as successful. I too am concerned that in some areas here and maybe in other parts of the region, we're not paying some interest in social studies, in Caribbean history. Why? I see the decline in human and social biology. And when you look at the chart, there are several other areas of significant decline. I know there are some students who believe that in a year you can take up a human and social biology text, read it, and go and do an exam. The teacher cannot be subtracted from your learning as students. They're integral. That partnership is an integral partnership to the success of students and their learning, students and their education. Not even the immersion of the technology that we're bringing to bear now across the region can eliminate the teacher from guiding, from inspiring, from motivating our children. So let's work the two together. Let's create all of the necessary and available partnerships that are important for the change of the face in this region. Even though we are having great success at agricultural sense, the numbers are small. So 100% might be 900 students. We're still not feeding ourselves. We're importing into this region yellow chicken. I hope somehow the skin of the chicken is yellow. I don't know why. I'm not a scientist. Maybe I should become a check and see what substance they were injected with. So we need more numbers saying the relevance at this foundational level of understanding true agricultural science, where we need to feed ourselves, if not 100%, as far as we can feed ourselves. The numbers on sports and physical education still is not as high as we should have, yet great percentages. Surely that is an area that more and more students can lean towards, and particularly in a region as small as we are, who produce some of the best in the world at every level. Juniors, seniors, in the case of Usain Bolt et al. Of course, I look forward to World Games. I hope that Usain can put his Gatling. I wouldn't call that word. I'm not only here, but I'm streaming worldwide. To shame. To shame, that's all I would say. But we have to see the practical applications of what CXC produces, what schools do to our living in this region and in the world. And students have to understand that. There's also a level of carelessness, the truth must be told, among our students, our elements of our student population. We can do better. If you don't prepare to pass, your lack of preparation prepares you to fail or to be unsuccessful. As minister in this country, and as I move around and as I talk to young people, I see some of the lackadaisical temperaments that are present. And if it is present in Barbados, I know it is present in Jamaica. I know it is present in Trinidad and Tobago and Antigua and Barbuda, because we're all one. So we have to change that. We have to link all of the partners together to ensure that our students see beyond the horizons for success. So we have to link families. And we remember what used to happen in Barbados, in the region, way back in the dark days when most of our children stopped school at 11 or at 12. And when greater liberation started to come, grandparents encouraging their grandchildren to learn and to learn and to learn. That should not change. So families have to refocus. Otherwise, gaps are going to start to appear, or greater gaps going to start to appear in our social fabric. Dangerously so. We have to have teachers fully focused, fully dedicated to transform children, to give them new hope, to give them new vistas, to give them new opportunities. It is not a lecture, it is a teaching. I'm seeing a bit too many lecturing. Leave that for university students. I want to see more teaching of our children. That's what we are paid for. Some people will get into the argument, but not enough. But when is enough enough? I always argue that I worked so hard and I didn't want a 10% cut, but I got it. I still live. So we have to give the kinds of emphases that are necessary to make our space better for our children, to change them or some of them from flowing in negative paths or directions. And you will see that ball starting to roll and starting to give us that true dimension of the change that we need for the better in our region. there's too much downtime in our classrooms every day. Every day. Too much downtime. We want more uptime. More uptime for the children's sake. That's what we need. So that the benefits, we can see them as real. We want to see them as real. So CXC can hold this and they do brilliant work. But the brilliant work is not reflected in the total outcomes or in the total outputs. We need to see it. Every country in the English-speaking Caribbean spends about 6% of its gross domestic product on education. And between 15 and 21% of government's expenditure annually on education. And we have to examine as taxpayers, as citizens of the region, if we are not shortchanging ourselves by the ultimate output in our various countries and in the region. We have to ask these questions. They're difficult questions to ask, but they must be asked. Otherwise, the Ministry of Health in Barbados will say, look, we give $200 million to the Queen Elizabeth Hospital, and we give you $500 million. We want $50 million because you're wasting it. I'm using a Barbadian perspective. So let us get the $50 million to make the people healthy. We don't want to surrender that. In fact, we need more. But we can only call for more when we are seeing the kind of dynamic changes and the dynamic results that we must have. Must have. Too many exit without sitting one subject. I look forward for the next 10 years. Hopefully, as Minister of Education in Barbados. And I want to thank my constituent. I know if it was just that one vote, I'll have 10 years, but as you can see, I'm growing old. You know, we have to pass to the youth. But the important thing is that whoever carries this major responsibility must be able to have that vision, transfer that vision, and have the collective. The total collective, that's the entire society, work to improve and to change what we're having coming out of our schools, how it's going to impact on the wider society, et cetera. CAPE, I took a quick look at Barbadian CAPE results. And I was discussing again with the registrar, there is a little difficulty in the shift from CSEC to CAPE Unit 1. And I picked it up quite quickly. Because if, in Barbados, we give these government scholarships and exhibitions, and I believe there were 52, most likely, you can add in that one, Mr. Price, 53. I told Cabinet yesterday that I'm going to come back because we tried to work it out quickly. I'm going to come back because there might be a few others that we might have missed in trying to get it done as quickly as we did. I'm not saying don't listen to the dull and the ignorant. They too have their stories. They too have their stories. But we must understand our story. We must understand our script. And we must be the one who play in the theater. We must know to whom we are responsible. And we are responsible to the nation. We are responsible for the nation's children. We are responsible to the families of the children. So whatever burden we carry, we must share those burdens and move forward with a clarity of purpose, with a vision to make it better in our region. Let me thank CXC for allowing me to visit this splendid headquarters. I wanted to visit it a long time ago, but the registrar didn't invite me. I'm told that it is opening in October. What's the date? 14th of October. I had a conference overseas, but I've asked the PARSEC to go so that I will be here and I get the grand tour that I think I deserve. This headquarters was built since I've been minister. I remember Dr. Jules visiting me several times, and he doesn't really cry, but he uses his mouth like a weapon. And therefore, we were able to get it done. I'm hoping that the facility and the conditions are extremely comfortable, and within the confines of that comfortableness, you would not stop producing, but that you will continue to grow. To all of those here in Barbados and in the region who will continue to work, I give you my thanks and the thanks of the Ministry of Education, not only here in Barbados, but right across the region, who are beneficiaries of what you offer to help motivate, to help inspire all of those who do exams in the region. May your successes continue, and may the people of this region continue to benefit from your work. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Minister. We certainly feel the passion and the call to action to stopping the leakage in the system. We just ask you to come forward for a short presentation by the registrar, who would now present the minister with a copy of the Barbados result. Just give us a minute for the media, the photographers to get in place as this is done. Thank you very much. Okay, thank you very much. Yes. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, at this time we will give you an opportunity to ask a couple questions or if you have any comments. There's a microphone in the aisle. You can come to the microphone to ask your comments of the CXC team. And we'll now open the floor for that. Please don't be shy. Going once. Mr. Dr. Brown, you get it? No? Going twice. Okay, I guess Dr. Mayanga's presentation was that comprehensive. Thank you very much, and we move right along. And right now I'll invite Mr. Fernando Carter from the Ministry of Education Curriculum Division to give the vote of thanks. Mr. Carter.
Master of Ceremonies. The Honorable Ronald Jones, Minister of Education, Permanent Secretary, Mrs. June Chandler, Chief Education Officer Acting and the other ministry officials, Mr. Glenroy Strawn, Mayor Glenroy Cumberbatch, and other CXC officials, seem to be thinking ahead of myself. Ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon to you. It is indeed a privilege and an honor in this esteemed company of policymakers, examiners, and educators to bestow the final assessment and to confer my stamp of approval and appreciation on the main actors in this ceremony. In fact, I will determine from a criterion reference point of view whether today's performances have reached acceptable levels of mastery deserving of certification. Topping the class of 2015 at this ceremony was the Honorable Ronald Jones, Minister of Education, who passionately reminded us of the symbiotic relationship between CXC and the Ministry of Education in Barbados and the role that partnership plays in raising the competence of our teachers and students. As a critical policy maker, Mr. Jones proffered credible pathways to continuous improvement in our pedagogy, reflecting his vast experience and understanding of the education system. As chief of the policymaking team, he recognizes the critical importance of relevant and timely data in effective decision making. Kudos to you, sir, for your forthrightness and your convincing remarks. We must confer to Mr. Glenroy Cumberbatch, CXC Registrar, an award of excellence and convey our gratitude for his comprehensive overview of the operations and performance of the Caribbean Examinations Council. In the recent times, he has also updated us on the path of CXC's evolution. CXC continues to model creativity and innovation in education while promoting the ideal Caribbean man for a better society. Mr. Noel Stennett, Senior Assistant Registrar, must be commended for exhibiting an excellent grasp of the issues and challenges encountered in the study and practice of examination administration. He qualified as an effective and meaningful communicator. And his twin partner, Dr. Charles Mayenga, Senior Assistant Registrar, whose extensive presentation enlightened and provided us with a good grasp of the intricacies of the examination, development, and production. We have a lot to be thankful for here in Barbados. Just as any good examination process requires a practical and interactive component, our ceremony would have been less engaging in the range of competencies assessed if not for the three following bonding agents. The entertainment by the Ace Works Community Steel Band, as synapses between the various subject remarks to comfort our souls and provide enabling set induction for the effective simulation of the many words of wisdom proffered here today. Thank you for your demonstration of superiority, especially in such young charges. We wish you the best in the future. You, the audience, must be commended. You recognize such an excellent production, and you may not have participated in terms of interaction, but you were very attentive and you were very patient, and we thank you for your presence here today. Our Master of Ceremonies, Mr. Cleveland Sam, the last bonding agent, you, like continuous assessment, monitored, lubricated, and facilitated our understanding and digestion of today's offerings. A top grade for a job well done. Special awards of appreciation and demonstration of competence must go to the Caribbean Media Corporation, the Media Resource Department of the Ministry of Education, Creative Junction, the enabling team from the local registrar, Mr. David Clement, and also to the IT team from CXC and the webmaster. We offer our sincere gratitude to all those persons not mentioned who have in some way contributed to the ceremony, and sincerely apologize to anyone we may have inadvertently omitted. Lastly, we would like to also thank Mrs. Jacqueline Chase Marshall, and who would have called on God Almighty for thanked him for bringing us here today and for this official release and for guiding and protecting us through our deliberations. Ladies and gentlemen, I have delivered on my stated objective. Our standards have been achieved at a high level, and I will now retire to allow you a chance to anticipate and experience the gastronomical delicacies to be provided. Thank you.
I think you should give Mr. Carter a better round of applause than that for a well done vote of thanks. And that brings us to the end of the proceedings for today. Thank you very much for joining us here. at the CXC headquarters, as well as those of you viewing via Carib Vision and on the World Wide Web via the CXC streaming CXC TV. Until next time, thank you very much and goodbye. As Mr. Carter said, there are some refreshments for you. You would be escorted to those refreshments by our competent ushers. Thank you very much.